first thought was that it was really heavy.
So, hilly,
first impression, Sheffield,
hilly. Ya, hilly lagi apa?
Sheffield, banyak bukit lah. Satu, one of the things that I won't miss.
So, what was your first thought when you first came to Sheffield?
You not being me.
Okay, chicken.
Well, the place. Well, actually, the place is quite nice. And then I'm staying near the university, so.
Well, before I went to the UK, my impression was that UK had high buildings there and it would snow like every other day. But when you come here, so I'm okay, that's just like normal buildings up. And when sampai di sini, pun rasa macam kan banyak tetamuan yang dibuat sampai tapi las-las macam mana saja.
First impression, Sheffield, pernah halalah di Sheffield ini. Banyak.
Banyak pulang.
Banyak.
Dalam satu simpang pulang.
Mula tu I expect macam saja orang yang ini friendly apa. But actually, they are really friendly. Tapi accent orang ni walaupun yang kami faham.
Well, my first thought was that it was really heavy and it was tiring. But then after that, I still liked it. I really liked it because it's a mixture of a city and it's also quite quiet, so it was a perfect balance.
What was your first thought when you first came to Sheffield?
Sheffield is more to student community, especially when you look around. Why I say that is because when it comes to summer, it looks like it's a ghost town. You go to Tesco, there's less people. You go to the town, there's less people as well. You get on the bus, also less people. So we call it like a ghost town when it comes to summer. Also because during my first year, I live in the university accommodation. And when it comes to the end of June or after exams, students basically go back home to their countries. So our area will be really quiet. So only the postgraduate students are left behind in our flat. So that's why Sheffield is a multicultural community and mostly students.
Masa my first year, aku tinggal jauh kan. And then kita galih lah kalau dari uni ke my place macam 20 minutes walk kan. And ya hilir lagi apa.
It was very sajok masa tu, and scary lah masa awal-awal sebab first time kan overseas, and then also and bridge up. But then when I got to know the people of Sheffield, they were very nice and they were very friendly lah, friendly.
Yeah. I've been here before actually, but macam, you know, like being here by myself, like actually leading a student life, macam.
I think I was quite excited, just to be kind of free.
Away from home.
Yeah, just to be independent.
Oh, mana pergi by kereta jalan kan?
I was kind of worried with like moving in to see her. Do you think about anything else except for, you know, going to our first class, my first class and stuff like that. Like I came here late, so the first thing I came here I did was to report to the uni, and then they just went like bahal kita class. I'm like, what? I'm not ready.
We were moving around and we were all settling down.
Yeah.
What is your best experience with BruSheff?
Best experience. Banyaklah basically, for activities macam BBQ, apa, amazing rest, friendly juga dia punya members ni.
Like in general, I would say all the gatherings, especially Amazing Race, because that was when I first got to know everyone, and I really liked it. It was like, it was a great, I don't know, like a really great first impression. Plus, we get to see the whole of Sheffield, and it was nice.
Meeting BruSheff members, attending some of the events, although I did not manage to get all of them, but there's some like, specific ones for the girls, like Tazki, which is the Quranic circle where we meet once in a while, once every week. And then there's also exam preparations where we have the Salat Hajat, we do things socially together. For the ECAs, I'm less into that. We tend to come and join just to observe, like attendance check. because we can't participate, so we just show our face and show our support for BruSheff.
The food, to be able to eat home food, and also to be able to hang out with friends and play games, just talk to them.
Yeah, getting to know like BruSheff, the students in it. So, kalau rasa homesick kan, mesti cakap semua orang Brunei. Feel like home.
Betul lah. You expect macam connection macam the big events kan yang kalau yang formal apa. Tapi it's actually yang the small events yang bagi yang siok lah. Like macam anything yang macam hangout lah macam movie night ke ataupun game night ataupun kerja yang betul lah yang dami-dami betul lah.
Basically. I think. Banyak pulang, but one of the best memories that I had was hiking the district for National Day. It was very tiring, but it was worth it because kami buat sama-sama. Yeah.
Big district. Yeah,
that's worth it.
That was my favorite. Yeah.
I wonder if like PLD and our showdown counts.
Well, for me, like, I just, you know, just seeing the other levers off on the previous levers nights, you know. It's because like it's a night of like seeing the seniors off, it's just celebrating their graduation and stuff.
So are you happy to see them leave?
Happy that they're, you know, motivated, finished with their studies.
Paintball.
Yeah, paintball is so nice as well.
Yeah. Second time.
I'm so quiet. Yeah. I'm very talkative housemate.
How does it feel like leaving Sheffield after studying here for a very long time?
I'm hungry.
Finally!
I think it's like different for different people.
Yeah.
Like, for some of them, they're continuing their masters, so they're still kind of like okay and everything. But some of us are actually gonna work after this, so
macam
it's a bit sad lah to think about it, but
macam dari belajar sampai kerja.
Yeah.
Transitioning from that phase of life, you know,
critical moments.
I think what Afa said is right, because I think some of us are pursuing masters, inshallah, but so we don't know how to feel yet, because we're not really leaving UK. But
sometimes macam masih ada lagi kau yang macam dah.
For anyone yang ada bucket list atau try to take all of your list, because traveling around Europe, meeting new people.
Target macam kan ke 7 wonders of the world kan, tapi ada berapa? 4 sudah kan?
3 or 4.
Rome, Pisa,
Paris.
Tapi belum lagi dapat lah semua. So, secepatkan travel-travel itu, all over sikit.
No, it's your time.
Is that actually for the same right question? Does it after 3 years of what you feel?
Third question is, how does it feel after 1 year being in Sheffield and now leaving?
It feels sad. Like, I mean, I'm glad that I'm like done studying. Not really, but I don't know, I have like a sense of regret too, because I regret not applying here for my undergrad, because if I knew it was this nice here, I would have applied here. Seriously.
How does it feel? It feels so short, honestly. Because it's actually a mixed feeling. One of it is, of course, relief. We've done the 3 years period of doing our degree, doing our assignments, endless nights at the library, doing past year papers, studying and everything. So at the same time, I feel sad to leave my friends behind, leave this opportunity behind. Because I know that when I'm going back home, it's hard for me to recreate this moment, studying in uni. So it's actually a mixed feeling for now.
We've come to Sheffield back in September 2012 with Dania. At that time was 1 year plus. We would say we'll miss Sheffield. So it's a different feeling going back to be a student back, and so that's a big transition for us, and adjusting, managing work, life, fun, and yeah.
Dania, do you have anything to say? Do you feel sad? Do you feel sad leaving?
Next question. What's your most memorable personal memory?
Generally.
Personal memory.
All together, yes. As a
group? Yeah. Oh. Together or individually. Not in Sheffield, together.
Have you seen our pictures? Like, we're always together and stuff like that.
Yeah, I guess the late mornings and what? You see
that? Late nights.
Yeah. Actually, late nights. Who know? Late nights and early mornings?
Yeah. Loud nights.
Loud nights and early late mornings.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then maybe for you guys.
Okay. Don't you guys remember when we went for KFC for the first time? We were so excited, come on.
It was like 3 years ago.
Yeah.
Well, you I remember
making a lot of plans but never went through with it. Like Cornwall, Black?
We're going
Blackpool.
I'm
not there.
Going?
Yeah, but we've made a lot of plans but we never really took people
to Spain.
Oh my god, stop it! I think the most memorable part in this flat is like cooking together.
Yeah.
That's what I always do anyway.
But well, for me, just looking at TV shows with my friends.
Yeah, Running Man.
Hey.
Cooking's more fun.
Cooking, yeah. Cooking was most of the.
Yeah.
Not really for like the rest of them, but.
Yeah.
I think for most of us, we actually like shop together and cook.
Yeah.
Together. So
yeah,
that's
I guess
the most memorable part.
I guess for me, I have like my gymnasium as a second year when I had that big room all to myself. Dan buat banyak orang, and then so many space for games.
Pertama sekali menjadi RO, dilantik sebagai RO. Dan bila dilantik RO tu, Alhamdulillah secara automatik dapat memahami Islam tu lebih mendalam. Dan dalam memahami Islam tu kan, bukannya just macam Islam bagi nama saja, tapi kalau kita ni memaham Islam tu, dalam segi perbuatan dan juga apa sajalah aspect of life adalah kalau ikutkan. So ada yang pertama. Yang kedua, best memory apabila dapat opportunity untuk berjalan ke luar negara. Seperti ke Turki, aku pernah ke France dan juga pergi ke Spain, Indonesia. Dan Paris tu, mesti kamu akan tahu di sini dan situ.
Guys, I think masa when I experienced the first snowfall here,
it's good.
It was very, wow,
to the end. But then, during my first year, I wasn't with like most of the BruSheff because I live far away. But it was still fun watching the snow fall, and the snow was very loud, so we had played for hours and hours, and it was very fun.
I guess today, it's more related to family members. Like, when snow comes, it's always thick snow, and we had fun playing in the snow, sledging down the hill, pulling Daniel along on the sledge, and then a fond memory of ours is when my sister actually slipped down the road with the luggage. So I know it's a bit naughty for me to make that as a personal memory, like it's like getting back on my sister, but it's a fond memory of us because that was the day when we all planned to travel to Paris and it snowed heavily. Luckily she's not hurt. She laughed along because her luggage was also with her. So I was like, are you taking an express train to Paris or something? Yeah, so that was our fond memory, especially when it's snowy.
Most memorable experience to me is when it was the first year, it was around January. When kami macam apa nih? I think I was at home kali, so lihat macam first time ada snow, so macam ni lapar, so like kena panggil lagi ke, oleh some of the members of BruSheff kan ke park main snow, and then it was like around 9 PM kali, so kami main snow di sana sampai like 1 AM. All of the Brunei people up on the down part, yeah, sakai lah tengah physically.
Do you have any advice for the juniors?
My advice for the juniors?
The prospective students coming to Sheffield as well.
New students. In terms of academic life, try not to just focus your life all onto your course. Meaning, I know you are here, sponsored or self-sponsored, to study, but at the same time try to have like a work-life balance where you also have fun, enjoy yourself, take the opportunity to challenge yourself to do things. For example, have you ever got a chance to travel by yourself in a foreign country? Or you're so used to Sheffield, why not once in a while challenge yourself, go to York by yourself without your Bruneian friends around you? Try not to be in a group all the time, or also try to mix more with the local people here or other international students, because from there you'll get a different perspective of how you see people and their culture and their religion as well to our culture. And then at the same time, by challenging yourself, it actually builds up your own confidence level. And you have something to say when you go back to Brunei, that I finished my course, but I did not just stay in my room doing my work, or I spent my whole night in the IC trying to finish things. And that's the only memory you have when you go back to Brunei. But what happens around you, social events around you, like social events in the city of Sheffield or other places. You can also go around with your friends, your group of friends, our normal Bruneian society, once in a while. But what I'm trying to say is not just stick to your own friends all the time, explore the world around you and just have fun.
think they don't know where we're.
Karao par, mati karao.
Hi, hi.
Tunggu yang cari lo.
Biar tadi kali
I won't be happy.
You're insecure, don't know what for. You're turning heads when you walk through the door. Don't need makeup to cover up. Being the way that you are is enough. Everyone else in the room can see it. Everyone else but you.
I say disco, you say party. Disco, disco,
party, party.
Like you seen him twirl, then he drop, nigga. And we keep the mind millies on my block, nigga. And Mate keep it on him, he done drop, niggas. And